Okay, good evening dear students. Okay, today we are going to discuss some MCQs based on so far what we discussed the concepts in redox reactions. Okay, now let us see the first question. The oxidation number and the number of SO bonds present in peroxydisulfuric acid respectively. Okay, actually this is the question which is asking from the previous JEE 2020, this one. Okay, first question. The oxidation number and number of SO bonds present in peroxydisulfuric acid. First question. First of all, what is peroxydisulfuric acid formula here? H2H2O8. Okay, if you know the structure only, you can able to write okay this what is the oxidation number and as well as SO bonds. S double bond O, double bond O, one peroxy bond will be double bond O, double bond O, OH, here OH. Okay, H2, two hydrogen atoms, H2O8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This link is called as here peroxy link, that's why it is known as here peroxy disulfuric acid. Okay, as we know, okay, now this oxidation state of this oxygen oxide, this is minus 2. Here minus 2, here minus 2. To satisfy the okay valency of this one, okay, to become neutrality, here minus 2, minus 2, minus 2, minus 6. Here what is the oxidation state? Plus 6. Okay, come to this sulfur atom here. Okay, here minus 2, here also minus 2, here also minus 2. Here, same like first sulfur atom here, here also plus 6 oxidation state. Okay, next one, what about this link is called as here? Peroxy bond or peroxy linkage. Okay, now each oxygen atom has minus one charge. Okay, now let me calculate here, okay, oxidation number. Okay, now plus 2 plus 2x plus, out of 8 oxygen atoms here, okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 oxygen atoms having the minus 2 its oxidation states, and these 2 oxygen atoms, because it is peroxy bond, 2 into each one is minus 1. Okay, is good. Minus 2, plus 2 cancel here. That implies x is equal to here. Okay, well, that is plus 6 oxidation state. This is the first, okay, well, they're asking number of oxidation state, okay, oxidation number and SO bonds. Now, let me calculate here SO bonds in peroxydisulfuric acid. Now, let me take it here. This is SO bond. Okay, this is SO and this is also SO. Okay. Next one, SO, here SO, 5 here, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. The number of SO bonds present in peroxydisulfuric acid is equal to 8. Now, okay, oxidation state is plus 6 and okay, number of SO bonds here, 8. Okay, wah. No, plus 6, 8, option D. This is the first question, dear students. Next one, come to the here, second question. Which combination is odd with respect to oxidation number? Okay, odd. Odd means it is a different oxidation state. H2SO5, as we calculated here in option A. Okay, H2SO5, okay, wah. Previous lecture we calculated here plus 6, H2H2O8, just now we calculated here also plus 6. Next one, K2Cr2O7 calculated here plus, okay, 6, SF6 here, in SF6, okay, X, sulfur, we don't know, plus each one, okay, fluorine atom minus 1 is equal to 0, X is equal to here also plus 6, all are plus 6. Next one, come to the option B, here, same plus 6, here also plus 6, CrO5. Very important this one, CrO5, okay, CrO5, actually this is the structure here, actually this structure name is called as here butterfly structure, double bond, okay. Now just I have check it here, here minus 1, here minus 1, here minus 1, here minus 1, this oxygen atom here minus 2, that means in okay, this one CrO5, okay, how many minus 1 charges are there? 4 minus 1, 4 into minus 1 plus this oxygen atom here, 1 into minus 2 is equal to 0, that implies x is equal to minus 4, minus 2 here is equal to total plus 6. Okay, now this is also oxidation state here, plus 6, and chromyl chloride, CrO2, Cl2, here also the same, CrO2, CrO2, Cl2, here also same, minus 2, here minus 2, okay, 4, okay, x is equal to here also, plus 6, here also all are plus 6 oxidation state. Okay, next one come to the here, NH3, x plus 3 is equal to 0, x is equal to minus 3, first one is a minus 3, next one, NH4 plus, that is ammonium ion, ammonium ion also here, NH4 plus X plus 4 is equal to plus 1, X is equal to here, minus 3 here. Next one, N3H, hydrozoic acid is, if you calculate, 3X plus 1 is equal to 0, X is equal to minus 1 by 3, and NO2 minus X minus 4 is equal to here, what will come here, plus 3, okay. Next one, D, same, okay, wow. Calcium hydride here, plus 2, barium hydride, plus 2, here plus 2, here also plus 2. Now check plus 6, here also plus 6, then which is the odd one here? Option C is the correct answer. Okay, option C. Okay, next one, third one, among the following elements, which one exhibit both both positive and negative oxidation state? Okay, let us do directly itself. Cesium, obviously we know, okay, it is metallic character from top to bottom in a group, it belongs to first A, having the, what is the charge here? Okay, plus 1. Okay, next one, neon, obviously it is inert gas, oxidation state 0. Next one, iodine, both what they are asking, one may exhibit both positive and negative oxidation state. Okay, iodine generally oxidation state we can call it is minus 1. Okay, oxidation state here, minus 1 halogen atoms. Next one, will it exhibit plus 5 oxidation state? Yes, will exist. What compound here? HiO4 per iodic acid. Okay, calculate here, plus 1 plus X minus 8 is equal to 0. That implies X is equal to plus 7. It is the strongest acid. Okay, more oxidizing nature. Here minus 1, here plus 1. Come to the here, fluorine. Fluorine exhibit minus 1 only because it has highest electronegativity. Its value is 4.0. Okay, from top to bottom in a group, electronegativity values are decreasing. Next one, potassium. Potassium also belongs to first A group element. It belongs to, it shows plus 1 oxidation state. So, option C is the correct answer, iodine. Next question, please. Question number 4 now. Okay, dear students, we can move to question number 4. Okay, in acidic medium, H2O2, hydrogen peroxide changes dichromate to CrO5, which has two peroxy bonds. Oxidation state of CrO5 is, just now we draw the structure, the same already, we can easily do it here. Cr, just now we drawn the structure, it is a butterfly structure. Cr, double bond O. How many oxidation states here? X plus 4 into minus 1 plus 1 into minus 2 is equal to 0. That implies x is equal to plus 6. What is the option? Option is C. Next, we can go for fifth question. Okay, for the redox reaction, okay, MnO4 minus plus, okay, oxalate in the presence of acidic medium to form Mn2 plus plus CO2 plus H2O. This is the redox reaction is given. Okay, now we have to balance the correct stoichiometric coefficient of permanganate, okay, next one oxalate and H plus ions are. Okay, now this already we done it one reaction, that is comes under, okay, balancing redox reaction in acidic medium. Let me take it here, MnO4 minus plus oxalate ion C2O4 2 minus, okay, in the presence of H plus gives rise to, in the acidic medium we already done it, Mn2 plus plus CO2 plus H2O. Just we are applying the rules here. First we have to balance all the atoms except oxygen and hydrogen. Okay, Mn is okay. Two carbon atoms here. I'm balancing here. Two. Next one. You don't take it to water now itself. Okay. Now step two, what you have to do? Balance the number of electrons. Oxidation state here, plus 7. Here oxidation state here, 2x minus 8 is equal to minus 2. X is equal to plus 3. Here each carbon, students have to note down here each carbon atom which shows oxidation state plus 3, but how many carbon atoms is here? Okay, 2 carbon atoms, that means 2 into plus 3, that means we have to please note down this is the plus 6 oxidation state. That's why each carbon atom here shows plus 3 oxidation state. Here plus 6 is there, here obviously we know it is plus 2. Okay, here carbon, each carbon atom here plus 4, but you have to remember each carbon atom plus 4, how many carbon atoms? Okay, 2, that's why 2 into plus 4, that is plus 8 oxidation state. Then after adding this one, we need to understand here what are the oxidation state here. Plus 7 to plus 2, how many electrons got transfer? 5 electrons. Okay, next one, come to the oxalate here, plus 6 to plus 8, how many electrons got transferred here? 2 electrons got transferred. Okay, to make the electron balance, what I said here, we have to multiply by, okay, to make the electron balance here, 5 is there, here 2 is there, there is no equality, that's why I can multiply by here, 2, here I can multiply by 5. So that, okay, equation, how the equation will form? Okay, if I multiply where here 2 will come, I multiplied, okay, next one here I'm taking, here also 2 will come, next one if I multiply here 5, okay, 5 I'm taking, here already 2 is there, 5 2s are there, I'm writing 10 CO2, then okay, electrons got balanced, and then immediately have to go for, okay, check for oxygen atoms here, LHS side how many oxygen atoms? 2 4s are 8 plus, okay, 5 4s are 20, total oxygen atoms here 28 on left hand side. Next one, come to the right hand side here, RHS. How many oxygen atoms, my dear? 10 into 2, 20 oxygen atoms are there. We already discussed here where the oxygen atoms deficient is there. For instead of one oxygen atom, we have to add, okay, one water molecule. That's why here, how many water molecules we have to add? 8. Is it left hand side or right hand side, my dear students? Very good, right hand side. How many? Here 20, here 28, here 8. That's why I'm adding here 8 H2O. At the moment you are, okay, balancing oxygen atoms, immediately you have to check for hydrogen atoms. There is no one hydrogen atom itself here. Here how many hydrogen atoms? 8 2s are 16. That's why I can add here 16 H plus. Whether the reaction is balanced or not, immediately you have to go for charges. Very good. Okay, now let me take the charges here. Minus 2 here. 5 2s are minus 10. Next one here plus 16. Here what is the charge, my dear students? Here 16, here 12, total here plus 4 is the left hand side. Here I can take it, 2 into plus 2, very good, plus 4. Okay, next one, no charges. This one plus 4, balance or not. Now what are the coefficients of permanganate? What is the coefficient of permanganate here? Very good, 2. Next one, oxalate ion, what is the coefficient here? 5. Next one, how many H plus ions? 16. Next you can go for answer, 2, 5, 16. What is the option? Option number A. Option number A. Okay. Next, go for question number 6. Next students, question number 6. If Cl2 is passed through hot aqueous NaOH, the products formed have chlorine in different oxidation states. These are indicated as, okay. Now we already know, okay, discussed, what is that one? When chlorine, which is treated with the hot aqueous NaOH, okay, here question number 6 I'm taking. When chlorine, which is react with the hot aqueous NaOH, how it is convert here? Okay, now let me take, okay, NaCl plus NaOCl plus H2O. Two sodium atoms are here. Now let me balance here, 2. Okay, now already we know oxidation state of chlorine here 0. Next one here, oxidation state here -1. Here oxidation state here +1. Okay, just you have to check it here. 0 to -1 and 0 to +1. Okay, is it comes under what type of reaction, my dear? Already we discussed in the first, okay, lecture, types of reaction: combination, decomposition, displacement and disproportionation. Okay, what reaction? Very good, disproportionation reaction. Same element which shows both oxidation and as well as reduction is known as disproportionation reaction. Next one, we can go for question number 7. Next one, equivalent weight of potassium permanganate in alkaline solution is equal to. Equivalent weight of potassium permanganate in alkaline solution. Potassium permanganate, okay, already we know potassium permanganate, okay, in weak, okay, in alkaline medium. Alkaline means here you can take it in OH minus, that is in basic medium. Already we know potassium permanganate, how it is convert in basic medium, weakly basic medium, it is convert into manganese dioxide or not, dear sir? Last class we discussed there. Okay, that means here oxidation state of permanganate is +7 or not? Yes. Next one here, what is the oxidation state here? X-4. That means what? +4 oxidation state. Is it? No. Then what they are asked us to calculate here? Equivalent weight. Okay. Now let me calculate equivalent weight. How to calculate equivalent weight, my dears? Equivalent weight is equal to molecular weight of the particular compound is divided by change in oxidation number. Okay. Change in oxidation number. That is equal to, what is the molecular weight of this one? Okay, you can take it here. They did not give the M. And how many electrons got transferred here? +7 to +4. How many electrons? Very good. 3 electrons. The M by 3 is the answer. That is, okay, 1/3 of the molar mass of potassium permanganate. That is option number C. Okay, please students, please note down. We can continue for the next questions. Okay, dears, next question number 8. In acidic medium, the equivalent weight of potassium permanganate is, okay, already we discussed here potassium permanganate, that can be taken as permanganate ion MnO4. In acidic medium, it is converted into Mn 2 plus. The same they are asking here. Okay. In acidic medium, the equivalent weight, same equivalent weight of potassium or permanganate ion is equal to gram molecular weight of the particular compound is divided by change in oxidation number. That is equal to here, we can take it, okay. I can consider this is molecular mass M, and how many electrons got transferred here? Here plus 7, here plus 2. How many electron transfer? Okay, 5 electrons or not, okay. That is M by 5. What is the option? Option number B. Okay, next one, question number 9. If you, okay, the reaction P4 plus 3 NaOH plus 3 H2O gives rise to, okay, 3 NaH2PO2 plus PH3 is an example of, okay. Now, previous class also we discuss, okay, well, this reaction is an example of neutralization reaction, pyrolytic reaction, double decomposition reaction, and this proportionation reaction. Okay, the neutralization is not because acid and base both will be combined. Pyrolytic it's not, okay. Metallurgy reaction, next one. Okay, double decomposition reaction. No, it is comes under here. This proportionation reaction. Direct, if you see the reaction itself, we can easily identify because both here phosphorus both act as a, okay, well, oxidation and as well as reduction. So option D. Go for next question. Question number 10. Next, the standard reduction, that is electrode potentials for metal-metal ion, okay, M2, M2 plus electrodes P, Q, R and S are respectively, okay, what is the standard electrode potentials? P, Q, R and S. Okay, standard reduction potential values are given. This value is minus 0.44, this value is plus 0.34, this value is minus 0.76 volt, this one is minus 0.25 volt. Simple, dear students, no need to confuse itself. Okay, well, most negative E0 value which shows greater, okay, reducing character, already we know. Next one, same, most positive E naught values it shows, okay, wow, maximum oxidizing nature, best ready, okay, oxidizing agents. Okay, let me start here. Okay, most negative value, which is the most negative among PQRS, most here minus 0.44, here plus, no it's not, minus 0.76 volts, actually minus 0.25, most negative, which is the most negative here, here 0.2, here 0.7, here 0.4, which is the most negative, this is, okay, first who will come? First option or next one, who is, okay, already we know this is Q is the least one, correct? Next one, if you take it here, okay, here minus 0.44, here minus 2, okay, 0.25. Now this is the next will come, then after this is P, then after R, Q, S, P, R, answer is Q, S, P, R, option is B. Okay, next question number 11, assertion. Copper is a stronger reducing than hydrogen. Reason, first of all, copper is a strong reducing than hydrogen. Okay, if you take the, okay, electrochemical series, the systematic arrangement of metals, okay, due to, okay, decreasing order of their reducing power or electron, okay, electrode standard potential values. Okay, now copper, for example, if you take it here, okay, now hydrogen will be here, then after copper, then after silver, then after RM, platinum, okay, this one, correct? Then here, what is there? First of all, if you take it the, according to our NCERT book here, this value becomes 0 plus 0.34 volt. Here value 0.0 volt. Okay, what is there? Copper is a stronger reducing than hydrogen. Those most electro, okay, negative E0 values are the best reducing agents. Okay, this is plus 0.34, that's why it can't reduce. That's why even copper, if you take the reaction like this, Cu plus 2HCl, generally in lower classes we used to write here CuCl2 plus H2, but will it possible this reaction? It won't possible because copper has less reduction potential than hydrogen. That's why this reaction can't, this copper can't be displacing from, okay, aqueous solution of the HCl. The reaction won't possible. That's why assertion A, assertion is wrong. Next one, come to the reason. Okay, Electrode standard potential of Cu2 plus 2 Cu is a negative. How it is negative? Okay. Now, generally metals are best reducing agents, obviously having the, okay, the negative is given. But copper has plus 0.34 volt, whereas zinc minus 0.76. It is a less reduction potential than hydrogen. That means assertion is wrong and reason also wrong. That's why what is option? Both assertion and reason are false. Option D. Go for next question. Question number 12. Next, the correct order of nitrogen compounds in its decreasing order of oxidation states. Decreasing order, okay, you can easily, very simple question. This is nitric acid, next NO, nitric, okay, nitrogen monoxide, next one N2 and ammonium chloride. Decreasing order they are asking. Okay, let me calculate here. Plus 1 plus x minus 6 is equal to 0, x is equal to plus 5. Here nitrogen, for all nitrogen compounds only we have to calculate. Next one, x minus 2 is equal to 0, x is equal to plus 2. Okay, next one N2 obviously it is okay elementary form 0. Next one, x plus 4 minus 1 is equal to 0, x is equal to okay plus 3. Sorry, x is equal to x plus 3, x is equal to minus 3. Okay, decreasing order they are asking. Next one, HNO3. Okay, decreasing order, that means okay, we have to take okay, HNO3, which is first, which is greater than decreasing order, means okay, 5, 4, 3, 2, like this. Next one, NO, which is greater than N2, then after here, NH4Cl. Okay, let me check it here. One more option, HNO3 plus 5, okay, NO. Wrong. Okay, next one, NH4Cl is coming immediately, minus 3. Next one, option B, 0, wrong. Next one, plus 5, minus 3, plus 2, 0, wrong. Next one, minus 3, 0, plus 2 and plus 5. No, they are asking decreasing order. Decreasing here, 5, 2, 0, minus 3. That is option number A. Next one, question number 13, if you check it here. How many peroxy bonds are present in CrO5? It's very important and very easy also. Okay, well, this is the what is the structure? Like this. What is it? Is it look like a butterfly or not? Yes, butterfly. How many peroxy bonds are there? Check it here. Bond O, bond O. This is one peroxy. Here bond O, bond O. This is second peroxy. Total how many peroxy bonds are there? There are two peroxy bonds are there. This is very, very important, dear students. Okay, now how many bonds? 3, 5, 2, 1. Option number C. Two peroxy bonds. Okay, next question. Question number 14. Okay, the number of SS bonds are present in SH molecule. Same, this question also, okay, ask in JEE 2020. Okay, in the last, okay, mains they ask. Okay, the number of SS bonds are present in SH molecule. SH molecule, okay. Already we know SH molecule structure, already we know that is known as, okay, crown like structure. Okay, now let me write here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. What they are asking, dears? Okay, number of SS bonds are present in, okay, SH molecule. SS bond they are asking. This is one SS bond. The SS 3, the 4, here 5, here 6, here 7, here 8. Total number of how many SS bonds are there? 8. What the option number? Option is D. Option D. Okay, next one, question number 15. Just I'm writing here. Try to understand. Question number 15. Okay, now the standard reduction potential for, okay, Al3 plus 2 Al, okay, Fe2 plus ferrous 2 ferrous, okay, ferrous 2, okay, Ir. Next one, Br2 Br minus R. Okay, how much they given? Al3 plus 2 Al, how much given? Minus 1.66 volt. Next one, minus 0.45, that is Fe2 plus 2 Fe. Next one, Br2 Br minus, how much? Okay, here 1.09, volt. Already we know, okay, one question also we done it, most negative electrode, standard potential value, which is the most electrode, okay, standard electrode potential value here, this is, that means here, let me consider this is A, this is B, this is C. Now I am writing here, this is A, then after, okay, after this one, most electronegativity, ferrous to iron, then after this one, A, B, C, that means Al3 plus, Fe2 plus greater than, next one Br. What is the option? Option number Al3 plus Fe, okay, option number A. Okay, dear students, okay, thank you for your cooperation. Okay, next one, total what we discussed concept and as well as we have discussed, okay, 15 MCQs and, okay, these all questions, okay, came from, okay, different competitive exams, okay. I hope everyone understood and maximum try to practice. This is the very right time to practice, okay, be safe at home and, okay, get ready for the your coming competitive exams. Thank you. Have a nice day.